When a girl crosses the threshold of Rachel's place, she makes that choice. She's saying, I'm going to live. She's saying, all the destruction in my life, all the negative things in my life are not going to get me down. Because it's a voluntary program. No one pushes anyone in. It's a choice.
Wonderful, special people who said, we want to make a difference in our community. There's a problem and we need to address it. It wasn't easy. It took a long time. It took tremendous effort and dedication and devotion. But finally, the dream is there. It's not happening, it's happened.
Rachel Mevakar Banaham, our matriarch Rachel, cries incessantly for her children. And we thought it was appropriate, because that's, in a way, what we were all doing. And certainly, we're hoping that her tears will always be there for us and work for us.
They don't want to sleep on the streets. They don't want to sleep on someone else's couch again, or with somebody who, you know, has got the fear of someone going to hurt them. So the initial thing is that they want that safety.
And it's the first sense of family that I've had in 6 years. Like Hani said, like, everybody's our sister, and it's like nice to come home and like have Jennifer here and Susie and Hani and all the other girls and make dinner and laugh and dance and like sit around
crazy,
and jump around
crazy.
The house. Like, I'm psychotic and I love it, and this house is great.
Over 3,000 kids sleep on the streets in the city of New York every night without a place to go. And these kids, by and large, have suffered the worst thing that can happen. They have not had a home life that was loving.
If anything happens to anybody, Jennifer's the first one, no matter what time it is, to come here and be here and calm, patient, and happy. And no matter if we did something wrong, she's always there. She's always gonna like tell us that we did it wrong, but in a nice way, so we shouldn't feel bad about it.
You know, this is a caring, loving environment. They do it at their own pace. We don't force or push anything on them. Once they feel safe, they start opening up to us and letting us know how we can help them more and how we can be more supportive to them and help
have a productive, sustainable member of society, someone who's going to pay taxes, someone who's going to be productive, someone who's not going to be a burden to society, but going to be an asset to society. So why we aren't out there making sure that every child that winds up on the street in this fashion doesn't have a shelter bed, a transitional living bed, is beyond me. And I will continue to beat that drum until it's no longer necessary to do it.
They're not doing it for any recognition. They're doing it because that's what they believe in.
Saving a life. When you save a life, it is as if you've saved the world. And that's exactly what Rachel's Place is all about.